हेलो फ्रेंड्स, कैसे हैं आप लोग। हम लोग इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स की बात कर रहे हैं और इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स में क्वेश्चंस पे अभी हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं। 1 से 24 तक के क्वेश्चंस पिछली क्लासेज में डिस्कस किए जा चुके हैं। आज 25 से आगे हम लोग क्वेश्चन डिस्कस करेंगे और उम्मीद है कि आपने पिछले जो 1 से 24 तक का क्वेश्चन है अच्छी तरह से रिविजन कर लिए हैं। कर लिए हैं ना, कोई दिक्कत तो नहीं। नहीं, ठीक है, ओके, ऑलराइट। सो आज 25 से आगे क्वेश्चन डिस्कस करते हैं और बिना समय व्यतीत किए हम लोग इस पे चर्चा करेंगे, आगे आज पूरा करेंगे इसे। ठीक है, तैयार हैं आप? ओके, तो ये क्वेश्चन है 25। देखिए क्या है ये 25 क्वेश्चन। एन ऑयल एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ 12 एक्सेस इलेक्ट्रॉन इज हेल्ड स्टेशनरी अंडर कंस्टेंट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ 2.25 × 10⁴ न्यूटन पर कूलम। मिल्कन साइल्ड्रॉप एक्सपेरिमेंट, द डेंसिटी ऑफ ऑयल इज 1.26 ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब। एस्टिमेट द रेडियस ऑफ द ड्रॉप। जी इज गिवन एंड चार्ज ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑल्सो गिवन। वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट दिस दैट चार्ज इज टोटल चार्ज हाउ मच, बिकॉज 12 एक्सेस इलेक्ट्रॉन इज हेल्ड स्टेशनरी। हेल्ड स्टेशनरी का मतलब ये है कि जो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा, ये इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड है, इसके अंदर ये ऑयल ड्रॉप स्टेशनरी है। तो ऑयल ड्रॉप, अगर मान लें कि ऑयल ड्रॉप जो है वो ऐसा है, कुछ इस तरह का ड्रॉप है और किसी इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड में स्टेशनरी है, इसका मतलब क्या है? नीचे नहीं गिर रहा है, नीचे नहीं गिर रहा है। नीचे गिरने के लिए इसका वेट लगता है, वेट इज इक्वल टू एम जी होता है। और इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड जो है इसको रोके हुए, इसका मतलब इस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड में एक इक्वल एंड अपोजिट फोर्स लग रहा होगा। इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी की वजह से यहाँ पे फोर्स लग रहा होगा कितना, F/Q फोर्स लग रहा होगा, जो कि इसे गिरने नहीं दे रहा होगा। यानी F इज इक्वल टू EQ, ये लग रहा होगा फोर्स इसके अपोजिट में, ताकि ये इसको स्टेशनरी में रख सके, है ना। अब दिया हुआ है इस क्वेश्चन में कि चार्ज ऑन ईच इलेक्ट्रॉन इज, एवरीबॉडी नोज दिस, 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ कूलम। तो चार्ज ऑन 12 एक्सेस इलेक्ट्रॉन है, इसलिए चार्ज ऑन 12 एक्सेस इलेक्ट्रॉन, 12 इलेक्ट्रॉन इज हाउ मच, 1 12 × 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ कूलम, राइट। सो 12 6 जा 32 72 एंड कैरी 7, 12 1 जा 12 एंड 7 19, सो 192, दैट इज 19.2 × 10⁻¹⁹ कूलम। दिस इज द टोटल चार्ज ऑन ऑयल ड्रॉप, क्यू ऑन ऑयल ड्रॉप, राइट। सो क्यू इज दिस, दैट इज क्यू इज दिस मच, गॉट इट, ओके। नाउ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज गिवन हियर, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज गिवन 2.55 × 10⁴ न्यूटन पर कूलम। सो ई इज गिवन हियर, राइट। So electric field is given here, E is given 2.55 into 10 to the power my 4 Newton per coulomb, okay, E is given. So force E is given, Q is calculated here. So what is force? And therefore force is equal to what? Force is EQ. That is 2.55 × 10⁴ multiply by 19.2 × 10⁻¹⁹. So that will come up here, because 255, let me calculate here, 250.55 × 19.2. That is 5 2 जा 10, 5 2 जा 10 1 11, carry 1, and 2 2 जा 4 and 1 5. Now 9 5 जा 45, carry 4, and 9 5 जा 45 and 4 49, carry 4, and 9 2 जा 18 and 4 22. am now 255 again. So 255 again. That will come up 0, 6, 5, 5, 10 and 1, 19. 9 carry 1. And 5 to 7 and 1, 8 and 2 to 4. Because decimal places are 3. So 48.960. 48.96. 96 into 10 to the power minus 50, right? So this is what? This is the force that is due to electric field. Force on oil drop due to electric field. Force exerted on oil drop due to electric field. But what is weight? Weight of this is, weight of oil drop. Oil drop is, weight is what? Mg. And mass is what? Volume into density. Volume into density multiply by g. So what is volume? Because oil drop is just spherical in shape. So we can write here density is given 1.26 gram per centimeter cube. So what can we write? 4 by 3 pi r cube. RQ into density is 1.26 gram per centimeter cube, that is 10 to the power 3 kilogram per meter cube. Density is given here. Since density is given here, density of oil drop is, density is 1.26 gram per centimeter cube. That can be converted in meter cube and kilogram per meter cube. Into, so multiply by 10 to the power 3, because multiply by here divide by 10 to the power 3 and multiply by 10 to the power 6, so it will be 1.26 into 10 to the power 3. So I can write like this, and density is 4 by 3 pi. Pi is 3.14 and g is here 9.81, that is already given. So 9.81 given, 3.14 into R cube into 1.26 into 10 to the power 3 into 9.81 or 9.8. Now, so what will happen? This force must be equated to this weight as the principle. So, therefore, since F is equal to W and this employee 48.96 into 10 to the power minus 15 must be equal to 4 by 3 into 3.14 into 1.26 into 9.81 into 10 to the power 3 into R cube, right? So R cube can, so R cube is equal to, in that case, what will be R cube? R cube is equal to, in that case, RQ is equal to, what will happen? 48.96 into 3 divided by 4 into 3.14 into 1.26 into 9.81, right? Into 10 to the power minus 15 and minus 3, minus 18, right? If I cancel this, two decimals and two place of decimals can be removed. And if I remove these two decimals as well, then what will happen? 10 to the power 4 will multiply here, right? And cancels all the h, then what will happen? This will be 4 can cancel this, 12, 4 is 48 and 24, 96, 12, 24 into 3. So this will be 12, 24 into 3, 3 can cancel this how many times? 3, 4 is 12 and 3, 2 is 26. That can cancel 21 times, and that can cancel how many times? Even 7, 6 can cancel. 6, 7 ja 42, right now? 6, 7 ja 42, and 6 can cancel this. 6, 2 ja 12, and 6, 4 ja 24. So 204. Now, so things will left out here, that 204 divided by 314 into 7 into 981, and that 40 will come here, right? And then 10 to the power minus 18. Even if I divide all these, then this will come up 0.0 946 into 10 to the power minus 18. So I can write here 946 into 10 to the power minus 21. I can write like this. So now R is equal to, what will be R? Even if I'm going to calculate R, then cube root of this will come. Therefore, R is equal to cube root of all these 946 into 10 to the power minus 21. And so 10 to the power minus 1 will come out, and that will be approximately 9.82 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. So radius of oil drop is this. Even better, you can write 9.82 into 10 to the power minus 4 millimeter. Radius in millimeter we can write. And this is the answer of this question. So hopefully you got it. Now the next question is, which among the curves shown in the figure 1.35 cannot possibly represent electrostatic field lines? We have already discussed that two characteristics you must take care of. One, that the electric field lines originate from positive charges and terminate at negative charges. So directions of lines, electric line of forces, originate from positive charges and terminate to negative charges. The second thing which is important and you must care of, that electric field lines do not intersect each other. The third thing is that electric field lines originates and terminates normally to the surface. So these things, if you take care of, you can answer this question. And this question, the first option is here, this is the Gaussian surface, but here you see they are not originating normally to the surface. It makes some angle, not 90 degree exactly, but lesser than. So it is not perpendicular, so that cannot be represented, since that will not represent, because since this one electric field lines do not originate perpendicularly, right? So that is why that will not represent electric line of forces. Here this is a positive charge, you see this is a positive charge, and electric field lines releases from there, originate from there and terminate to negative end. So this is correct. But here again, from negative, the electric field lines originate. So electric field lines cannot originate from negative charges. Nets from negative charges. So that is why that will also not represent electric field lines. In C, this is the positive charges, this is the positive, so originates, and they, because they repel each other, so such electric field lines will form when two positive charges are close to each other. So that will represent, there is no doubt about it. We have already discussed this in classes. And fourth one, here the electric field lines intersect. Electric field lines do not intersect each other. Field lines cannot intersect each other. Cannot intersect, because at point of intersection there will be two directions. So that is why cannot intersect each other. So that is why that will also not represent. Cannot intersect each other. Sect. So here intersection takes place, and that is why that will not represent. Here this is a field. There are two regions by which we can say. One, that originates not normally. Second, that here is a closed loop formed, and closed loop cannot be formed in the electric fields. So that is why closed loop cannot be formed in electric field. Right now, so that is why this will be not also correct answer. So only C is the appropriate answer. I hope you got it. Hello. So ye question hai, in a certain region of a space, electric field is along the z direction throughout. The magnitude of electric field is however not constant, but increases uniformly along the positive z direction. at the rate of 10 to the power 5 Newton per coulomb per meter. What is the force and torque experienced by the system at total dipole moment equal to 10 to the power minus 7 centimeter in the negative z direction? This is given in centimeter, 10 to the power minus 7 centimeter in the negative z direction, right? 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb meter in this negative z direction, not centimeter, it is a coulomb meter. So what is given here? Dipole moment is given, that is P is given 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb meter. This is what given. And direction of electric field, the magnitude of electric field is not constant but increases uniformly. It means rate of change of electric field with respect to per meter distance, say L is the distance, so d by dl is equal to 10 to the power 5 newton per coulomb. We know dipole moment is what? One of the charge multiply by the distance between them, so q into l. L is the distance and here rate of change of distance is given. So a small distance, because it is can be written as dl as well, so q into dl is dipole moment, so p is equal to q into dl. Here rate of change of this electric field is given, and also there is given that electric field is along the z axis, z direction, whereas positive z directions, no, electric field in along positive z directions, and the force experience and torque experience by dipole having the total dipole moment equal to this in negative z direction. So I want to tell you that what will happen. Agar ye koi electric field hai, maan lijiye, aur is electric field mein koi ek dipole rakha hua aisa, right? To is dipole ki ek hai ye z axis, ye hai z axis maan lete hain, ये है y एक्सिस और ये मान लेते हैं कि x एक्सिस है। तो z एक्सिस के डायरेक्शन में इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन इधर की ओर बढ़ रही है और डाइपोल मोमेंट जो है वो इधर नेगेटिव z डायरेक्शन की ओर है। सो व्हाट विल हैपन? अब इसमें हमें ये निकालना है कि d by dl ये क्या है, फोर्स कितना होगा, फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस कर रहा है, तो फोर्स इज इक्वल टू क्या होता है, फोर्स f इज इक्वल टू क्या होता है, QE होता है। अब यहाँ पे Q है, अगर हम इसे रेट ऑफ चेंज d बाई dl से डिवाइड कर दें तो dl से मल्टीप्लाई करना पड़ेगा। ये dE बाई l जो दिया हुआ है बेसिकली, इसको आप E बाई l भी लिख सकते हैं, तो ये हमने dl से डिवाइड और dl से मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया। Q इंटू dl क्या हो जाएगा, ये हो जाएगा Q इंटू dl डाइपोल मोमेंट P, और d बाई dl हमें दिया हुआ है, तो ये हो गया p इंटू डी बाई dl। अब d बाई dl दिया हुआ है 10 टू द पावर 5 न्यूटन और डाइपोल मोमेंट दिया है 10 टू द पावर माइनस 7, बट ये निगेटिव z डायरेक्शन में है इसलिए माइनस लिख देंगे, और ये 10 टू द पावर 5 है पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन में, यानी माइनस 10 टू द पावर माइनस 2, ये हो जाएगा न्यूटन। इतना फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस करेगा, तो हमें जो निकालना था कि फोर्स कितना एक्सपीरियंस करेगा, वो 10 टू द पावर माइनस 2 न्यूटन का फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस करेगा। किस डायरेक्शन में, फोर्स वेक्टर क्वांटिटी है, तो इसी डायरेक्शन में, ये फोर्स के डायरेक्शन में, अलोंग निगेटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ जेड एक्सिस। अब सवाल है कि ये टॉर्क लग रहा है इधर की ओर, फोर्स लग रहा है उधर की ओर, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन ये है, टॉर्क की डायरेक्शन ये, फोर्स की डायरेक्शन ये है, फोर्स की डायरेक्शन ये है, दोनों के बीच में एंगल कितना बन रहा है जी, 180 डिग्री। तो टॉर्क टाउ इज इक्वल टू क्या होता है, पी साइन थीटा। थीटा कितना है यहाँ पे, 180 डिग्री, और इसलिए हो जाएगा पीई साइन 180 डिग्री। पी की वैल्यू, ई की वैल्यू लिखने की जरूरत भी नहीं है। साइन 180 कितना होता है जी, जीरो। साइन 180 होता है 0 डिग्री, तो जीरो होने से ही पूरा का पूरा टॉर्क क्या हो जाएगा, जीरो। इसका मतलब हो गया कि कोई टॉर्क एक्सपीरियंस नहीं होगा और यहाँ पे टॉर्क हो गया कितना, जीरो। फोर्स तो एक्सपीरियंस होगा बट टॉर्क एक्सपीरियंस नहीं होगा। तो ये टॉर्क जो एक्सपीरियंस करेगा, जो सिस्टम है जो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड के अंदर रखा हुआ है, उस पे जीरो टॉर्क लगेगा। आई होप यू गॉट इट। चलिए अगले क्वेश्चन की तरफ पढ़ते हैं। इन दिस क्वेश्चन सी ए कंडक्टर ए विथ कैविटी एज शोन इन द फिगर 1.36 इज गिवन अ चार्ज क्यू सो दैट द एंटायर चार्ज मस्ट अपीयर ऑन आउटर सरफेस ऑफ द कंडक्टर। इफ समवन से दैट एंटायर चार्ज लाई आउटर सरफेस ऑफ द कंडक्टर, इट मीन्स वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द चार्ज इनसाइड द कंडक्टर इज जीरो। वी नो दिस बट वी हैव टू प्रूव दिस। अनदर कंडक्टर बी व्हिच इज अ चार्ज क्यू, अ स्मॉल क्यू इज इंसर्टेड इनटू द कैविटी कीपिंग बी इंसुलेटेड फ्रॉम ए, देन टोटल चार्ज it will be on a is q plus q, that is total charge will transfer outside of this cavity. A sensitive instrument to be shielded from the strong electrostatic field in its environment suggests a possible way. Let us consider the first part of the question and then we will discuss the remaining one. In this part it is given that this is a charge body, a conductor A, this is a conductor, and in this conductor there is a Gaussian surface, Gaussian surface is made. This is the possible Gaussian surface outside of this conductor, and Q is the charge given to the conductor. A conductor A with a cavity as shown in the figure, there is a cavity, this is a cavity and this is a conductor, and is given to charge Q. Q charge is given to it. So that the entire charge must appear on outer surface of the conductor. We know the total electric flux through a surface is what? Phi is equal to E dot dA, A is the area, or E dot dS. You can write anything, right? So here E dot dA. And or even ds you can write. Also, according to Gauss theorem, total flux is what? Total flux is phi is equal to 1 by epsilon times of the total charge. It means E dot dA is equal to q upon epsilon naught, right? Okay, now total electric field inside the cavity is zero, since electric field inside cavity is zero, and therefore since E is equal to zero, q is also zero. From the first, 0 into something is 0 because epsilon naught is not 0, right? So q must be 0. So total charge inside the cavity is what? 0. And therefore whatever the charge is given to this, that will be transferred to the outer surface, and therefore the charge Q, which is given to the body, given to the conductor, will transfer completely outside of the surface. Right? I hope you got it. Now the next part of the question is, if another charge body B is inserted in A, independent insulated from A, and that has given a small charge Q, then what will happen? if this will be given and there is a plus charge, then interiors inside of this there will be minus q charge will develop, and since inside this surface minus q charge will develop, so plus q charge will develop outside, and therefore this plus q charges which is develop outer surface of this, and earlier there was a plus q charges, so now next total charge will be q plus q. So that is what we have to write here. This is what you can write here. Here, what we can write here, let me write outside of the surface. Therefore, completely outside of the surface. Charge will transfer completely outside of the surface. Since plus Q charge inserted, therefore, minus Q charge developed inside of conductor A due to induction, right? Induced charges, and therefore plus Q charge will develop outside of the surface of conductor A, surface of conductor A, and therefore total charge on outer surface of conductor A, on outer surface of conductor A will be Q initial, and this one is Q which is developed, right? Now the third part of the question is whether this can be a sensitive instrument, can be shielded from a strong electrostatic field. The answer is yes, it can be shielded by a metallic electrostatic shield. If it is covered by a metallic shield, right, then it can be protected, because metallic sheet and anything cavity cover with metallic conductor, metallic surface, if it is enclosed in it, then it can be protected from outside environment, and therefore electrostatic shielding can be possible. Because if there is anything which is kept inside this, and there is a metallic surface inside this, then it behave like electrostatic shielding, and things will be inside of this will be remain protected from outside any electric field or any kind of electrostatic attraction or repulsion. So it can be shielded. Okay, so this will be the answer. Given here that question is question number 29. Here is question number 29. A hollow charge conductor has a tiny hole cut into its surface so that the electric field in this hole is sigma upon 2 epsilon naught n, where n is unit vector normal to the outward normal direction, and sigma is the surface charge density near the hole. This question is given like this. Suppose this is a hollow conductor, right? A hollow charge conductor has a tiny hole cut into its surface. Suppose one cut here, a small hole here, right? This is the hole. So here the normal is like this, n is normal to this. And due to this charge cut conductor, here some charge body is also there, charge is also there. If cut, then charge on the surface will be there. And due to this, some electric field is also releasing electric field outward. And charge here, electric field also, because it is a charge conductor, so electric field is, charge is moving from positive to negative. Hollow charge conductor, tiny hole cut into its surface so that the electric field of the hole is this. Since electric flux E is equal to E dot dA, right? This we know already. dA is the normal to the area, or ds, some people may write ds, E dot dA. And also flux is equal to total charge upon epsilon naught. So we can write here that sigma upon epsilon naught is equal to E dot dA, right? And both are in same direction, so this will be zero. Q is what? What is Q? Q is the total charge. Sigma is surface charge density, so Q is equal to sigma charge per unit area is surface charge density, that is sigma. So sigma Q is equal to what? Sigma into dA. Sigma into dA, for a small area we can write dA. So sigma is sigma into dA is upon epsilon naught is equal to E into dA into cos 0, because angle is 0 degree. So dA and dA can cancels out, and cos 0 is 1. So what will happen? E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. This is the electric field, right? Electric field. Now total electric field is sigma upon epsilon naught, total electric flux, total this has been calculated. But here there are two type of electric field will come. One, the electric field is due to cavity. Electric field is due to cavity, say E dash is the electric field due to cavity, and electric field due to rest of the charged particle is also E dash. Both are inside conductor, both of them are equal and opposite, and hence they will vanish each other. But outside of the conductor, both having the same direction, and therefore net electric field will be E dash plus E dash, that will be 2 E dash. So E dash plus E dash is equal to net electric field, that is E, and 2 E dash is equal to E, and therefore E dash is equal to 1 by 2 of E, and E is already calculated how much? Sigma upon epsilon naught. So 1 by 2 sigma upon epsilon naught. So sigma upon 2 epsilon naught is the net electric field, and direction of this will be in the direction of N, because it is the in the direction normal to this cavity. So net electric field at in this cavity is outside, normally outward you can say, and that is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. And this is the answer of this question. This is what we have to prove. So the electric field in the cavity, electric field in the cavity is E dash, and that is equal to 1 by 2 epsilon naught into sigma into N. This is what we have to do. Now let us discuss question number 30. Obtain the formula for electric field due to a long thin wire of uniform linear charge density lambda without using Gauss law. Ek wire hai, x y ki length maan lete hain. Iska ek midpoint maan lete hain, O. यहां से L डिस्टेंस पे एक पॉइंट मान लेते हैं P, जहां पे हमें इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कैलकुलेट करनी है। एक पार्ट ले लेते हैं यहां पे O से और यहां पे Q, ये पॉइंट है जहां पे हम इसका डिस्टेंस x मान लेते हैं, ये डिस्टेंस x है, और इसकी वजह से अभी हमें यहां पे पूरे वायर की वजह से कैलकुलेट करना है, लेकिन फॉर्मूला डिराइव करने के लिए एक छोटा सा सेगमेंट हमने ले लिया x। ये इसके साथ थीटा एंगल बना रहा है, कितना एंगल बना रहा है? थीटा। तो ये थीटा एंगल इसके साथ बना रहा है। अब इसका एक छोटा सा, चूंकि हम लेंथ ले लें x लेंथ पे, इस सेगमेंट पे पूरे वायर की जो चार्ज है वो है q, तो लीनियर चार्ज डेंसिटी जो है dx लेंथ के लिए कितना होगा? अगर इसमें छोटा सा एक सेगमेंट हम मान लें dx, dx सेगमेंट ले लें, तो इसका चार्ज हो जाएगा लीनियर चार्ज डेंसिटी dx लैम्डा इनटू dx, दिस इज द अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज, और इस चार्ज की वजह से ये q चार्ज हो गया dx एलिमेंट की वजह से, और इसकी वजह से इस जगह पे इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, तो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, राइट, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड फील्ड एट p ड्यू टू ए स्मॉल चार्ज एलिमेंट small charge element of length dx is given by is E is equal to what d, that will be also a small charge. So d is equal to kq upon r square. R is distance. So here what is the distance? Distance from q is this one, l square plus x square under root. So what will happen here? R square, instead of r square we can write l square plus x square whole square under root l square plus x square ka whole square. So that will be kq upon l square plus x square, and q is what? Lambda into dx. Q is nothing else but lambda into dx. So we can write electric field at age, electric field age k into lambda into dx upon l square plus x square. Okay, from this, by trigonometry, we can write theta is equal to, this x is given, l is given. This is the perpendicular, that is opposite side, this is the base. What is the relation between them? Tan theta. So, tan theta is equal to what? X by l. And this employee x is equal to l tan theta. We can write. And if I write dx, so what will happen? Dx is equal to l, and derivative of tan theta is sec square theta d theta, right? So dx can be write sec square theta d theta. Also l square plus x square is what? X square plus l square is what? X square plus, in place of x we can write l tan theta. So that will be x square plus l square. So x is l square tan square theta plus l square. So I can write l square common, and what is that? Tan square theta plus 1, that is sec square theta. So l square sec square. Now this electric field has two component. One is perpendicular to this and another is horizontal. So electric field here has two component, one in direction of perpendicular and another in direction of horizontal. So this will be dE cos theta. Of course, you know the theta base wala dE cos theta, aur ye hoga dE sin theta. Is direction mein jo electric field hogi for long wire, ye kya ho jayega? Ye vanish ho jayega ek dusre ke sath. Yahi wala electric field is point pe reh jayega. ये जो है इनफाइनाइट लॉन्ग वायर के लिए ये वैनिस हो जाएगा. अगर पूरे वायर को कंसीडर करेंगे तो जितना इधर होगा उतना ही इधर होगा, इसलिए पूरे वायर को कंसीडर करने के पास डी साइन थीटा जो होगा वो कैंसिल हो जाएगा, रह जाएगा डी कॉस थीटा. सो हियर द कंपोनेंट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट ई विल बी एट पी विल बी dE cos theta, right ना? E1 मान लेते हैं, इस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड का नाम देते हैं E1 is equal to dE cos theta. अब d के बदले क्या लिखते हैं? d के बदले लिख देंगे यहां पे ये cos theta, d के बदले k lambda dx upon l square plus x square into cos theta. And now putting the value of all this, dx is what? Dx we have already calculated here, that dx is l sec square theta d theta. And so dx is k lambda dx is l sec square theta d theta, and this one is l square plus x square is l square sec square theta, or ye cos theta. ये sec square theta, sec square theta l से l कट गया, तो बच गया k lambda into cos theta upon l into cos theta d theta, right? ये बच गया, ये हो गया electric field E1, right? अब हमें इससे total electric field चाहिए, तो हमें क्या करना होगा? Integrate करना पड़ेगा. So total electric field electric field due to full wire, full conductor, since it is of infinite length, is given as E1. आप इसको चाहें तो DE1 लिख सकते हैं. अब इंटीग्रेट करेंगे तो E1 is equal to integrate of DE1. कहां से कहां तक? लेंथ है माइनस पाई बाई टू से पाई बाई टू. इनफाइनाइट लेंथ होगी इस पॉइंट से, तो यहाँ के डिस्टेंस को ये पैरेलल मानी जाएगी, तो ये माइनस पाई बाई टू, और इधर भी पैरेलल मानी जाएगी, तो इधर प्लस पाई बाई टू. सो माइनस पाई बाई टू टू प्लस पाई बाई टू, एंड दैट विल बी गिवन एज के ए लैम्डा अपॉन एल कॉस थीटा डी थीटा. कहां से कहां तक? माइनस पाई बाई टू से पाई बाई टू तक. इसमें से के लैम्डा बाई एल तो बाहर हो जाएगा, और ये रह जाएगा माइनस पाई बाई टू से पाई बाई टू कॉस थीटा डी थीटा. कॉन्स्टेंट बाहर हो जाता है. आपको बताइए कॉस थीटा का इंटीग्रेशन क्या होता है? माइनस साइन थीटा, सॉरी कॉस थीटा का साइन थीटा होता है. तो ये हो जाएगा के एल अपॉन के लैम्डा अपॉन एल, के लैम्डा अपॉन एल, के लैम्डा अपॉन एल, और ये साइन थीटा, और कहां से कहां तक? तो माइनस पाई बाई टू से पाई बाई टू तक. दैट कैन बी रिटन एज के लैम्डा अपॉन एल साइन पाई बाई टू माइनस साइन ऑफ माइनस पाई बाई टू. तो ये हो जाएगा साइन पाई बाई टू वन, साइन माइनस पाई बाई टू इज माइनस साइन पाई बाई टू, तो वन प्लस वन मिलकर क्या हो जाएगा? टू. तो ये हो जाएगा टू, यानी के लैम्डा अपॉन टू एल. ये हो गया इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. K का मतलब 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught lambda upon 2L, right ना? 2L, sorry 2 ऊपर चला गया ना, 2 तो ऊपर आएगा, 2 ऊपर आएगा, so 2 into 2. अब ये हो गया 2, और ये lambda है नीचे, ये 2 यहाँ नहीं रहेगा, so 2 and 2 4 can cancels out, that is lambda upon 2 pi epsilon naught L. ये होगा टोटल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एल डिस्टेंस पे किसी पॉइंट पे विदाउट यूजिंग गॉस थ्योरम. वी कैन कैलकुलेट इट एंड दिस विल बी द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. आई होप यू गॉट इट. नाउ लेट अस क्वेश्चन नंबर लेट अस डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 31. इट इज बिलीव दैट प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स व्हिच कंस्टिट्यूट न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ एन ऑर्डिनरी मैटर आर देमसेल्व्स बिल्ट आउट ऑफ मोर एलिमेंट्री यूनिट्स कॉल्ड क्वार्क. A proton and neutron consist of three quarks each, two types of quarks, so called up quark denoted by U of charge 2 by plus 2 by 3 electron, and down quark denoted by D of charge minus 1 by 3 of electron. Together with electrons build up an ordinary matter. Quarks of other type have also been found which gives rise of different unusual variety of matter. Suggest a possible quark composition of proton, a proton and a neutron. The proton has three quarks. It is given here in this question. Proton and neutron has each of them has three quarks. Right now? So we can calculate for protons and neutrons separately. First, let me consider that protons has two type of quark. Some of them is up quark and down quark. So let the proton is combination of, let proton has n up quarks and 3 minus n down quarks, right? Quarks, because total quarks is 3, each of them has 3 quarks, right now? So proton and neutron are made of 3 quarks and consist of 3, and therefore since n is up quark, then 3 minus n down quarks, so therefore total charge on each up quark is 2 by 3 electron plus, so therefore total charge on n up quark is how much? N times 2n by 3 of electron plus charge, right? Similarly, total proton n 3 minus n down quark, so total charge on charge on each down quark is minus 1 by 3 of electron. So charge on 3 minus n down quark is how much? 3 minus n times of minus 1 by 3 electron, that is n minus 3 by 3 of electron, right? And as it is given, the total charge on proton is plus C, right now? Total charge on proton is plus C. So what will happen? Total charge on proton is what? Proton is E. Total charge on proton is E. Proton is E. And therefore, 2n by 3e plus n minus 3 by 3e is equal to E plus E. So we have to calculate now what will happen. 2n plus n minus 3, because LCM of this is 3 upon 3 is equal to 1. EE cancels out. Now 2n plus n is 3n, right? So 3n is equal to 3, and this minus 3 will come also this side, plus 3. So 3n is equal to 6, and therefore n is equal to 2. It means in proton there are 2 up quarks and 1 down quarks, and therefore in proton up quarks 2 and down quarks is 1. Now let me consider for neutron as well. So similarly, one can write here that n up quark on neutron will make it 2n by 3e, and n minus 3 by 3 on e is equal to 0, because there is no charge on neutron. And in that case, what will happen? 2n plus n minus 3 by 3 is equal to 0, because e cannot be 0, and therefore 3n minus 3 is equal to 0, that is 3n is equal to 3, and therefore n is equal to 1. So in neutron there is, in neutron up quarks 1 and down quarks. This is the combination. So that will be the answer of this question. I hope you got it. Okay. Now let us discuss question number 32. Consider an arbitrary electrostatic field configuration. A small discharge is placed at its null point. Electrostatic field configuration where a small discharge is placed at its null point of the configuration, so that the equilibrium of discharge is necessarily unstable. Verify this result for a simple configuration of two charges of the same magnitude and sign placed at certain distance. To answer this question, we can write here that suppose E is this. This is the null point here, right? This is the null point. Just I have written here. And here this. If the charge is stable, means what? Stable means anything. Stable means if you slightly displaced it in any direction, it will come to its own point. For example, if this is stable, then I can say whatever the position may be changed, slightly displaced, it will come to its original point. So similarly, if the charge is placed at null point and charge is displaced anywhere in any direction slightly, then it will try to come back to its original position, that is at null point again. It means there is some force acting towards this null point, and this force is electric line of forces coming from this enclosed surface, electrostatic fields. So all this net flux will coming towards it, and net flux will be there, right? Now inward flux will be there. According to this, there is net inward flux will be there, net inward flux, but there is no charge stored. So according to Gauss theorem, if there is no charge enclosed by any system, then net flux will be zero, because flux is q by epsilon naught times. And since charge is not enclosed, charge is zero, therefore flux is also zero. But here net flux is observed, and therefore it is not possible that charge is stable. Charge is necessarily unstable. Now the second part of the question is that suppose a linear verify the configuration in two charge of the same magnitude and sign placed in a certain distance apart. Suppose here is a plus q charge and here is a minus q charge is placed, right? So at this, the null point, middle point, the net flux is, net electric field is zero, right? Here net electric field is zero. If this is the null point, say this is what? Null point. Midpoint is null point. Now if charge is slightly displaced from here, then what will happen? This will try to restore here again. If charge is slightly displaced here, then that will restore, try to restore, restoring force act on it, and that will bring it to this middle point. Okay. But if the charge is slightly displaced in from there, perpendicular to its direction, then net force here will be not zero, and a restoring force will not come into action. Here some force will remain, because it will be like this, you know, already we have calculated, it will be directed outward, this will be directed inward, you know, and therefore, because it will be directed inward, and therefore a parallelogram law will be there, and in this parallelogram law, the net force will be like this. So here net force will be this, means there is no restoring force is there, which will bring it at its original position. It means this is not in equilibrium always. If it will displace in the direction of charges, whether it's slightly this direction or this that direction, then it will a restoring force can come into play, and that will bring it in the mid position. But whenever it is displaced in the direction of perpendicular to it, then it will restoring force do not bring it its original position, and therefore we can say this is not in equilibrium, because in equilibrium, if it is displaced in any direction, irrespective of here and there, or vertical or horizontal, or parallel or perpendicular, it should be a restoring force act in the way so that it will bring its original position. But this is not in that case, and therefore it is necessarily unstable. Now let us discuss next question 33. A particle of mass m and charge minus q enters a region between the two charge plate initially moving along x axis with the speed vx, that is like this vx. Length of the plate is l, and in uniform electric field e maintained between the plates, so that the vertical deflection of the particle at far edge of the plate is this much, q l e l square upon 2 m v x square, like this. So this is what we have to probe here. Two plates are there, and charge mass of particle is, mass of particle is m, particle is m, and charge h, charge on particle is, particle h, what, minus q. This is what given. So for moving, there is a length of plate. Length of plate is L. Plate is L. So to move, and velocity of charge particle is also given. Velocity of charge particle along x axis, vx along x axis, along x axis is vx, right? So time taken to cross length L is what? Distance is, time is equal to distance upon speed. So distance is L and speed is Vx. So time is equal to, therefore time is equal to what? T is equal to L upon Vx. This is equation 1. Now, why this will move? Because of some mechanical force acting on it, and force is equal to force, mechanical force, which is provided by electrostatic field force. F is equal to what? M into A. And this force is provided by electrostatic field, that is Q into E is equal to M into A. And therefore, A is equal to QE by M, right? QE by M. Now, in vertical motion, because plates are parallel and motion is along x-axis, so in vertical direction, the initial velocity is 0. And this velocity is Vx, Ux is Vx, but Uy is 0. Uy is 0. And therefore, what we can write? The distance, if it is deflection, is S distance above it in the direction vertical displacement. If vertical displacement is x, displacement is S, then S is equal to ut plus half at a square. This is the formula, and here it will be uy, that is S is equal to uyt plus half at a square. Ui 0. So that will be half a t square, since u y is 0. Now A is what? A is already we have calculated q e by m. A is q e by m. So we can write A is equal to q e by m. A is equal to q e by m. A is q e by m. So S is equal to QE by M, and T is what? T is L upon Vx square. So that will come 1 by 2 QEL square divided by M into Vx square. This is looks like horizontal projectile motion, and this is what we have to prove. I hope you got it. So electric field is given here, that electric field is, distance of separation is also given. Electric field is given 9.1 into 10 to the power 2 Newton per coulomb, and distance of separation, say S, is given here what? 0.5 centimeter, that is 5 into 10 to the power 3 meter, right? Now, what is given? And where will be the electron strike upper plate? Because there are two plates, electron is moving from lower plate to, and it will strike upper plate. So what is the distance that we'll have to cover? The distance of separation of these two plates is 0.5 centimeter. This is what given. So that distance we have to calculate S. That we have to calculate S is given. We have to calculate length L. L is what? So in this formula, we have to calculate L. L we have to calculate, right? So where L it will strike? L it will strike upper, where the electron strike the upper plate. Charge on each electron is also given. Charge on each electron is given. Charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And mass of electron is also given, 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Now, what was the formula? Formula was, see, S is equal to half QEL square upon M, QEL square upon M Vx square. Half QE upon M, this is for A, and L square upon Vx square. So, since in this previous question, it was S is equal to half QE by M L square upon X square, Vx square. So, L square we have to calculate. If we have to calculate L square, then what will happen? 2S into M into Vx square upon QE, and therefore L is equal to under root of 2 into S is what? S is 5 into 10 to the power 3 into mass of electron is what? 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 into Vx square. Vx is what? 2 into 10 to the power 6 and whole square of it. So that is in numerator. In denominator, what will happen? In denominator, it will come like QE. Charge on electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and electric field is given also slightly. Electric field is given 9.1 into 10 to the power 2. 9.1 into 10 to the power 2 Newton per coulomb. So this 9.1 and this 9.1 will cancel out. 5 to the 10. So what will happen? L is equal to 1.6. Right now, this will be L square is equal to this much. So 1.6 Q is 1.6. And this is 2 square is 4. So 4 into this will be 10. So it will be 4 into right here. 2 square is 4. And this is 4 upon 1.6. Or even we can write 10 to the power. This is 4. 5 into 2, 10. 10 to the power 4. And 6 to the 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. And 10 to the power minus 31 plus 16 is 10 to the power minus 15. Minus 15 and plus 19. So 10 to the power 4. 10 to the power 4 minus 2 is 10 to the power 2. So 10 square divided by, this is all, what about? If I remove this decimal, then 110 will be multiply here. This will cancel 4 times, and 4 cancel this 2 times, and this is 5 times. So 2.5 into 10 to the power 2. So L is approximately 2.5 into 10 square. 2.5 into 10 square. 2.5 can be written as, this is 250, right now? So 250, that will be approximately 1.6, because 2. centimeter. 256 is 1.6, so that will be 1.6 centimeter. So this electron will strike, strike at distance 1.6 centimeter approximately. This is the answer. I hope you got it. So that's all on this topic, right? We will start next topic in the next class, and we will discuss all those things which is required for the next topic. So till then, bye bye. God bless you.